The 2024 North Carolina High School Athletic Association 3A state title presented by West Shore Home. It's a new familiar place for 71st. They made the final 2 years ago, came up short. Central Cabarrus dominant. They've won 64 straight games and look to bring home back-to-back state titles. Welcome to Joel Coliseum with Jay Sunhalter. I'm Evan Budjervich. 71st has been on the doorstep two of the last 3 years. Central Cabarrus, the longest winning streak in the country. Jay, how do these two programs pull out a state title?
Well, it's going to be an interesting matchup because of the contrast of style for Central Cabarrus. They can really dominate in their half-court offense. But for 71st, they can shoot the ball at a high level from beyond the three-point line, and they want to play up-tempo.
You mentioned that offense. Jacquez Foster leads the charge for 71st. What must he do tonight for this Fayetteville team?
Well, it's hitting that outside shot. He was outstanding on Tuesday in the regional final, pouring in 25 points from 5 for 9 from beyond the three-point line, and he can create for his teammates. This is a balanced starting five for the Falcons, and he can get everybody involved. And for Central Cabarrus, their star senior, Desmond Kenton Jr., at 25 points and 8 rebounds on Tuesday in their regional final win. He's committed to Lees McRae. He's dominant in the paint area, Evan. He can step out and shoot it from the outside, and he's an enforcer on the defensive end.
Two electric players. Here's our Ingles food for thought. For this Falcons club, what must they do to start strong tonight, Jay?
Well, they got off to a 15-5 start in the first quarter of their last ball game. They want the same result here tonight, and then their outside shooting, connecting and taking good shots will be important. Over on the other side for Central Cabarrus, playing up tempo, fast pace, and then the turnover margin are going to be their focus areas.
Gearing up for a fantastic state final here in 3A basketball. This broadcast is brought to you by West Shore Home. We have opening tip in a few minutes. 71st back in a final. Central Cabarrus, they want to go back to back. We'll find out next when we return. Welcome back to Joel Coliseum, gearing up for this 3A state championship. 71st back in a familiar spot back in 22 and 24. Central Cabarrus, they won two of the last three, and these head coaches are excellent. Jeremy Ingram was the MEAC Player of the Year just a decade ago at NC Central, and Jim Baker, a 30-year coach in the college ranks, now the high school ranks, and he's looking for back-to-back state titles.
Two of the top coaches in the state, their players play so hard for them. They're disciplined ball clubs, and not surprised they're here in the state championship because of the leadership for each side.
Jim Baker, a longtime assistant at Davidson, Vatek, and VMI. He's taken this job with the reins here at Central Cabarrus. Not only a 64-game win streak, they have dominated opponents on this playoff.
It's been so impressive because they've just steamrolled through the season, through the playoffs. And this is a balanced scoring group. Everybody gets involved. Very talented star seniors, talented underclassmen. They've got a big test with 71st here tonight.
71st has won 17 straight games. The lone player from that 22 championship run is their quarterback, DeAndre Nance, who just lost in the state football final 4 months ago. He'll look for retribution tonight for his Falcons out of Fayetteville. Central Cabarrus out of Charlotte from the Concord area. And let's get this state championship game underway, the 3A men's final. Central Cabarrus, a nice win over a very good Hickory team by 9 earlier this week. On the first possession, Kent down low. He is right to work. Dominant effort. Josh Dalton nearly layup. This is a 71st offense. They score just under 60 a game. More defensive-minded as that three is off from Mylon Campbell. Now the point guard, Chase Daniel, whose twin brother, Carson. Those are fantastic guards. They combine for 15 assists a game to lead this offense. And they're fading the paint early. Two buckets for Dalton.
And Dalton, he's a force on the interior. 6'9". Averages around 16 points per game on the year.
Central Cabarrus applying a ton of pressure on the pass. This is what makes this team dangerous. They get out early, they work with leads. Daniel, returning starter with his twin brother. And Desmond Kent, the player we mentioned in the open, he's going to Lees McRae. He's a shot-blocking machine.
Yeah, the defensive end, they excel, force difficult shots for their opponents. They're talented on the offensive end.
That is short, but an offensive board for Carson Daniel, playing his 109th game tonight. That shot no good, and a good board for DeAndre Nance, the quarterback of this offense, literally, on the football field. That time, though, a turnover, and here's the starting lineup for the Falcons of 71st. Xavier McBride's a big-time scorer at 4 a game in spots. Jacquez Foster, though, double figures coming in.
Yeah, and Campbell, DeAndre Nance, those two high scorers. And this is a group that got off to a fast start Tuesday night. They want the same result here tonight.
Early paint touches for Josh Dalton, but he misses the jumper. In that Hickory matchup, there were 40 points in the paint for Central Cabarrus. They pounded the ball down low, including Desmond Kent with the double-double in the win. This defense will pressure you 94 feet. They make it hard. Good ball movement, Nance. Has an option. That's no good. Second chance, no. And after the miss from McBride, a rebound for Central Cabarrus. Here comes Daniel into traffic, and what a start for the reigning state champs.
They're hot right now, pushing the pace, using the tempo. They excel the fast break opportunity, and they convert it there.
71st on this end. No easy looks and another turnover. Here comes Kent. Kent is trapped. That's okay. He's going to solution it. 8-0 in a timeout, 71st. A 64-game win streak forcing the timeout for 71st. We'll step aside during the 3A state championship. Right to the West Shore home. Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Hot start for Central Cabarrus. They've made 3 of their first 4. Now go out of bounds. And right now, Jay, if you're 71st, how do you find rhythm offensively?
Well, that was a good timeout by Jeremy Ingram, just to slow things down and just kind of getting your half-court offense, knock down a shot. Good looking possession from Mylon Campbell there. They just got to knock down one bucket, getting the rhythm on the offensive end.
There was a clock malfunction, so they'll reset the clock here. Everything's been fast in the start, maybe except the clocks. If you're Central Cabarrus right now, 64-game win streak. Club that averages 4 double figures coming in, including the fantastic twin brothers, Chase and Carson Daniel. A couple of seniors ending their career tonight. Here's Carson with it. Carson, the crossover, finds his shooting partner at Edmiston, misses. Look at the boards and Desmond Kent all over it.
He's relentless on the glass with his length and effort. Those second chance opportunities have been huge for the Vikings this year.
71st needs a bucket. It's an alley-oop attempt that goes out of play. That size and athleticism is causing problems defensively.
And with Dalton and Kent at 6'9", 6'6", shot blockers, and they're very active.
Dalton, who has HBCU offers, he'll play at the Division I level next year. Dalton lets it fly. Good looking shot. Nice rebound from Mylon Campbell at 13-5 in the region final win over Westover. Great spin move, and the teardrop is affected by the size of Dalton. Here comes Daniel. That pass is intercepted. Campbell the other way. Campbell is fouled. And a chance for the first points for 71st.
Well, excellent work from Mylon Campbell on the defensive end, creating the turnover, stopping the momentum. And then there it is, clubbing that ball down and going all the way. They didn't have numbers, but he just forced the issue to get to the line.
Mylon Campbell, who averages 15 a game, he's been big in these moments. That's the first of Riddle and Brantley free throws. Riddle and Brantley injured an accident called Riddle and Brantley when justice counts. And down 10-0, justice needs to be served to the Riddle and Brantley right now.
Well, that was a good take because Campbell, the leading scorer, had to take over, had to create an opportunity to get his team on the board.
Central Cabarrus riding this nation-long 64-game win streak. They were tested in the region final against Hickory. And now an offensive turnover there. A rare travel. Head coach Jeremy Ingram, a MEAC Player of the Year at NC Central. He's electric as a player, leading this young team. And that's goaltending. The basketball counts. So there's the first points in the field for 71st.
Xavier McBride. Good take here by the junior. Get the call for the goaltender.
Daniel enters the lane. That's too easy.
And he is so shifty, quick, elusive. He can take you off the dribble.
Carson Daniel, 22 points in the region final. He'll also dish the rock well. And a nice finish underneath for DeAndre Nance, the quarterback of the football team.
Don't you just get the feel that the Falcons more comfortable now, past couple possessions, getting into a rhythm.
Kent, 1v1 and a swat. Second chance in. His size makes an impact.
He is so long, but that style that he plays with, he can kind of slither around you. Good touch. He followed it up there.
He has Anthony Davis type wingspan at 6'9". Makes it hard for the defender. And the second chance affecting the shot. Great tip in. That was Caden Diggs going after it, the 6'8 junior.
For him, his length down low, battling the two bigs for the Vikings. His play is important tonight.
Kent on the shot fake. He's got some range too. Wow, that's a great looking jump.
He is so smooth and he can score from all three levels.
Kent with 6 early points. Now he'll play hard defense. The tip drill, no. Loose ball to the Vikings. Brother to brother connection. The Daniels will back it out. Here's Chase. How about the range? And this, another 3 for Dalton. 6'9 from college range with a Meg Brown 3-pointer.
Well, when he can shoot that outside shot, knock him in from beyond the 3-point line, it's going to open up driving lanes for him as well.
DeAndre Nance searching for real estate. Daniel is an elite defender. Now a double team comes, getting the ball out of the hand of Mylon Campbell. Campbell splits the double. Open shooter, Foster, and Jaquez hits the 3.
Good start for Foster, knocking it in, and you're right, that double team came up. Campbell split it to find his open teammate.
Now a chance for 71st in transition. All of a sudden, open shooters here. A 3-pointer, Nance misses. And we have an offensive foul on this end. Caden Diggs over and back. There are some electric, long, lean forwards in this matchup.
There is talent in this ball game, and guys are gonna have a future at the next level.
That's the first foul, so he'll sub out. And Xavier Williams, the junior, comes in. It's a 71st program under Jeremy Ingram, who made the state final 2 years ago and came up just short. Lost by 10 in that championship game. They've been to the final now 5 times, but yet to win one as a program. Tough driving lanes. In comes Jake Baker, the junior guard for the Vikings. Daniel on the drive, and he misses. Free throws here for twin bro Chase Daniel.
Vikings do a nice job with their spacing, clearing out the floor. Dribble penetration, a lot of contact there as Daniel goes towards the hoop.
That's a Riddle and Brantley free throw line. Riddle and Brantley injured in an accident call. Riddle and Brantley when justice counts. With some early foul trouble, in comes Julian Wilkerson, who's hit 30 threes this year off the bench. He's been electric as a junior guard. A much smaller lineup now for both teams. And the lead is 10. In the hands of Nance all night, and that pass again over his target. A player who threw for 2,000 yards, has over 100 assists. He's trying to navigate a tough defense.
Yeah, this defense, this pressure is really tough to get through. Already 5 turnovers by the Falcons.
That 3 is off. Offensive board, Russell. And it will stay here. What about 71st? Do we get a couple of stops on this end?
Well, the first thing is just try to stop the dribble drive, stay in front.
Then Russell knocks in a 3. It's a Meg Brown home furnishings 3-point shot.
Difficult to defend that 3-point line when they shoot it at a high level.
Now ball pressure on Nance. He's got to let it go. 7 turnovers for 71st. What a nice dime. And Staples missed the layup. The Vikings doing everything right in this first quarter. Kick out. Russell resets. Everyone touching the rock. 5 assists for the Vikings. Daniel breaks ankles and is fouled. Good luck stopping Carson Daniel.
He's so quick. And with his ball handling ability. It's like he's got a string, bringing the ball left to right, crossover dribble. He knew he had that left side to get into the paint.
Carson Daniel, the Catawba commit, misses the first free throw. Riddle and Brantley free throw line. Riddle and Brantley injured an accident call. Riddle and Brantley. I love his teammates telling him, hey, bend your knees a little more on that free throw. I guess the advice paid off. Largest lead of the game for the Vikings, the reigning state champs of 3A basketball here in North Carolina. Nice job breaking the press. Newton has his shot blocked, and here comes the size of Kent behind the back. And Desmond Kent, he's a difference maker, that senior forward.
With that pressure that they bring, if they get beat, they've got the height with Kent and Dalton down low to make stops in there. Perfectly timed block and leads to offense.
Daniel's turn. Knocks in another three. And it ends the first quarter. All Central Cabarrus in this first frame. Shooting at 60% and locked in for back-to-back titles.
They're doing it on both ends of the court on offense. From beyond the three-point line, they're on fire.
Here are your law offices of Roderick Todd McIver's stats for the first quarter, and the real story is Central Cabarrus at 60% from the field.
Yeah, doing a good job protecting the basketball, getting extra opportunities on the glass, but the key's been they're taking good shots at them, and they're knocking them in.
Also, our Piedmont Federal Bank points in the paint. Both teams shooting more from the outside, but three threes for Central Cabarrus counters these points in the paint. A red-hot offensive start for the reigning state champions. And now a nearly turnover force. There's Daniel flying towards us. Chase and Carson Daniel, they've been outstanding this season. They both average 5 assists a game and over double-figure points for the dynamic duo. DeAndre Nance tries to break this press. That forced 5 turnovers, make it 6. Showtime for Russell on the layup.
This pressure is creating issues for the Falcons, leading to another bucket.
Nice floater on the other end. Russell there to finish that time. Pardon me, McBride finishes that time.
And that's how you break through. Quick passes up the court, attack to the middle. McBride, second time, has finished out the rim.
Daniel Brothers playing catch. As an offense, they make 7 threes a game. Good balance for Central Cabarrus. They also have size down low, and a miss that time for Desmond Kent. Nance on the move. DeAndre, great pass and a nice finish. That's the ball movement 71st needs.
Beautiful there with the passing. Quick back and forth, making it difficult to defend.
Not just an all-state quarterback, but a pretty good point guard as well, DeAndre Nance. He led his 71st football team to a state final in the 3A against Hickory. In fact, the Cabarrus win over Hickory avoided what could have been a first-time ever football-basketball double final between the two programs.
And he's a really good player. You talk about his passing ability. It's his vision as well. He uses it on the football field, here on the court as well. He can see his teammates open. He reacts and anticipates plays.
Here's DeAndre Nance. Another nifty pass. That time, Kent stole it. As the Daniel brothers. Daniel goes up strong, tip drill dunk. Whoa. And a timeout for 71st. No answers for Central Cabarrus. We'll take this timeout as the reigning state champs up 17. They're moving in transition in search of back-to-back state titles. Coming up in the fourth quarter on 988 Suicide and Crisis Prevention Hotline play of the game. Maybe that tip back dunk is an early contender.
Yeah, there's been a couple opportunities we could pick from here. Really strong start to this game.
Coming up in the fourth as well, our West Shore home player of the game. Bath Remodeling made easy. A lot of options for Central Cabarrus early. 10 for Kent, 7 Dalton, 5 Russell. It's the balance that makes this team dangerous.
Yeah, they hit you in waves and everybody's getting involved in the offensive end of the court. Supremely talented group.
DeAndre Nance looking to orchestrate the comeback here for 71st. fifth ever appearance in a state final, but they've never won. And a steal for Josh Dalton. What a find to Kent. It's like watching two aliens, Kevin Durant like bodies on the court, making things happen. And a foul for Desmond Kent. It's one thing to be tall and athletic, but then to have the IQ at the basketball level.
He plays with effort, too, on the defensive side. He was at the top of the press. He's who knocked that ball loose. And then talk about his IQ. Plays the game. So smart. Makes the right play.
Bangs home the Carolina Hurricanes free throw. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. Fifth free throw attempt of the night for the Vikings. That one is off. Central Cabarrus, who's only lost three games in 4 years, and a nice bucket there for Mylon Campbell. Daniel shows off the vision. Look at how everyone touched the rock for the Vikings. Another pass and a dunk. Josh Dalton, the beneficiary.
Well, there's the rotation with the ball, moving it left to right there. And Dalton, he's going to finish it right around the rim.
Eight assists. And then another alley-oop. Good finish for Caden Diggs.
Nice job there getting the ball to Diggs. And he was kind of hiding below the hoop. Nobody saw him there.
Is this slam ball with all the trampoline dunking? Because that ball is recovered on the board. Two uber athletic teams. Nance forces a pass in and a turnover. You can tell DeAndre Nance is playing chess and maybe sometimes hoping his teammates can join him and not checkers.
And here on the fast break, there's the rotation. Dalton finishing with a nice pass from Daniel. And then alley-oop. Diggs knows what to do with it.
Those are 2 6'8" forwards getting after it. Dunk v. dunk. Daniel with the handles. And then Dalton has range, but he does travel that time. So now for 71st, Jacquez Foster will come back in. In the regional final, 25 points. They need to untap that tonight.
Yeah, he lit up from the outside, shooting the ball. He was really efficient and 5 for 9 from beyond the three-point line.
Great hands from Mylon Campbell. Now McBride the lob, which might have been a shot, could have been a lob, instead a turnover. Carson Daniel running the break, finds the big man and feed the beast down low.
And they're just hustling down the floor, getting position.
That's 11 for Dalton and 11 for Kent, the two forwards. They have been the SWAT kings here in Winston-Salem. Look at this double team pressure. 71st has got to find the open man. Instead, a missed layup. And on this end, it's too easy. Daniel again. Kick out, open three, knocked in. Edmonston from downtown. It's the Meg Brown Home Furnishings three. Stopping at Meg Brown today to take advantage of their anniversary sale. And Central Cabarrus, Jay, taking advantage of these fast break plays.
Transition buckets and on the run. Fast break has been good to the Vikings. Edmonston finishes it off with the three.
This blade is ballooned to 21 late in the second quarter. The Central Cabarrus team that was trailing in the third against Hickory had to overcome a really good regional final. Made them battle tested for this championship.
A tough ball game. They persevered, handled it in the fourth quarter, and now playing at a high level. Only 3 turnovers so far.
Stay tuned for the Popeyes halftime report. We'll have a special interview with Q Tucker, the commissioner of the High School Athletic Association. Highlight some more Popeyes Love That Chicken from Popeyes. Gotta love the ball distribution too if you're Central Cabarrus right now. They've hit 61% of their shots. And to their credit, they have 9 assists on 16 baskets.
And sharing the ball and getting good looks. It's putting a lot of pressure on the defense of 71st because they have to move their feet, defend the whole court. And with the athleticism and the inside play with Dalton and Kent, it's so tough to defend those two.
Undefeated regular season for this program, 32-0 after a fantastic 26-3, or pardon me, 30-1 record the previous year. The longest win streak in the country, 64 games for Central Cabarrus. 7. He first breaks the press. Remember, the Falcons lived on the three-pointer. They had double-digit threes and a win on Wednesday. Not many openings here. Tough drive and a nice finish. That's a good solution.
That was a really difficult shot by Campbell. Nice job, Jeremy Ingram, calling the timeout and getting the bucket.
Here is Chase Daniel, fellow twin brother. Daniel, nice moves. Now twin part two, Carson Daniel. No look pass, big three. And a miss. His vision's next level. Hello, DeAndre Nance breaking down the defense. And oh, what a swat. How did Kent get his hands on that? Dillon runs the other way and missed it. Whoa, Dalton wants that back. Mylon Campbell, good kick out. Nance for three, that's a big shot.
There it is, a three-point shot is one of the strengths. That's how they get back into this ball game, is knocking those down.
That's a Meg Brown home furnishings three-point shot. Kent the other way pressured. 71st enter this game, making 5 threes a night. They just hit their first. And Kent is in his bag, 13.
Versatile game on the offensive end. So smooth, mid-range jumper has been there all night.
There's a steal. Kent on the run. Oh, my goodness! He's taking this game to new heights, Jay.
He's got a dominant talent. He's going to have a bright future at the next level.
Now a double team inside, and the fast break game is moving. From brother to brother, the lob, the block, and the foul as DeAndre Nance prevents this place from rocking.
Here we go. Oh!
You hear the ahs and the oohs from the crowd watching the replay
here in
the Joel for the Carolina Hurricanes free throw. Go to Hurricane, go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. Let's go, Canes. '71st searching for answers. They'll bring back in Noah Staples and Xavier Williams. And this combo of Dalton and Kent are all over the place, absolutely dominant. 27 combined points as Jake Baker will check in. Active hands again, a steal for Russell. Scoop shot, Russell calls bang. How do you stop this locomotive?
That was amazing. Great touch for the finish.
DeAndre Nance splits three, lays it off, and Williams missed the layup. Nice drive, though, from Nance. Patient offense for Central Cabarrus. Are shooting 60% in the first half. 1v1. Daniel. All the moves in the world. Ran out of options. Right back to him. Daniel, no look dime. Russell lays it off and a foul. Even when you guard him hard, Central Cabarrus has answers.
That was good defense. It was just the ability to find an open teammate and then you get the baseline. And then Kent is so smart. Goes in towards the hoop, crashes in to get the pass.
See the look on Jeremy Ingram's face. He'll need some help from his defense here. And good luck stopping this dynamic duo for the Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. Go to Carolina, go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. Let's go, Canes. As Caden Smith will give Carson Daniel the breather down the first half. A rare miss from the free throw line for Central Cabarrus. 71st breaking down the press really well until a turnover. That's the 12th mistake. Daniels ahead of the pack. Baker, he tripped. Somehow that was caught, and Kent puts it in for 17.
Well, just find Kent. He'll clean it up.
He's Clark Kent, yeah. But the cape is Central Cabrera's color. Whew.
Big first half.
Good luck stopping one of the best players in the state. Here's a loose ball. The shot is no good. Hold on, we have a jump ball. Everybody's okay.
Well, this game means each side just wrestling for the ball. So it's a jump ball.
Stay tuned for the Popeyes halftime report. We'll have a special interview with Q Tucker, commissioner of the North Carolina High School Athletic Association. First half highlights and more. Popeyes, love that chicken from Popeyes. Gotta love the start of Central Cabrera, 63% shooting. Three near double figures. Russell blocked to end the half. And it is all Central Cabrera's right now in search of back-to-back state titles. A 50-burger in the first half.
Well, coming out here on the defensive end, they set the tempo, creating turnovers. It led to offense, and on that end of the court, everybody's getting involved, and they're taking good shots, and they're able to execute, especially in the paint.
Gear up for our Popeyes halftime report, but enjoy some dunks from the high-flying Vikings of Central Cabrera's here on West Shore Home.
You're watching the Popeyes Halftime Report. Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Well, hey there, everybody. Thank you all so much for tuning in to the state championship high school basketball games. Joining us is our longstanding partner all the way from Ingalls Markets, Miss Melissa Level. Melissa, are you loving these excellent basketball games?
I love it. What a great season it's been. And the best of the best is right here now on television.
Best of the best is right. Now, let's talk about that longstanding and robust partnership between Ingalls and high school championship athletics. What all does that entail?
That it's just absolutely wonderful to be able to connect with all the schools within our region. You know, we're in six states, and so we have Friday Night Lights with football, we do basketball, we have softball, some Olympic-style sports, and we go all the way up through college, and then of course some minor leagues. But we just love that high school spirit and the fun with that. A lot of those players work with us.
That's
a lot of their parents have shop at our Ingalls, so it's kind of like a big family coming to watch all of them play, right? So we love that.
We love it as well. Melissa, as always, thank you for taking the time to speak with us here today.
Thank you.
Alrighty, let's get back to the game, folks.
You're watching the Popeyes Halftime Report. Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Commissioner Tucker, we appreciate your time. Before we begin, congratulations on being inducted to the North Carolina Sports Hall of Fame.
Well, thank you very much. That certainly was an honor that it really caught me by surprise when I received that call early in December. And still am very humbled. They found me worthy enough to be included in a mix of some really outstanding sports figures in North Carolina.
What preparations have been made to ensure a smooth running of the basketball championships?
You know, storming the court after a game has become one of those familiar sights as we've watched the colleges play and even football contests. So we have been working with the folks at Lawrence Joel, as well as our, host school system to try to make sure that we do not have anything that resembles that. So we've tried to do all we can to make sure that it's, easy to get into, and that once you're inside, that it is an enjoyable experience, whether you're actually on the court playing, on the sideline coaching, or you're sitting and watching as a spectator.
Can you highlight any notable changes to the format this year compared to previous years?
All games are in the same venue. In the past, we've played at Reynolds Coliseum and the Dean E. Smith Center. And so we've had classifications at two separate sites. Well, this year, everybody's at the same site.
How does the basketball championships benefit the student athletes' growth and development in the educational framework?
The attention to details, recognizing that you have to persevere. You have to be determined. You have to set goals. And this will just be a continuation of that.
Commissioner, what's been the biggest challenge for the association in the last year?
I think there is this this idea out there, Jay, that we are the ones who make the rules. Those of us who come to work every day that we hold the authority and we have the power, which is so untrue. We have 436 member schools right now, and we work for them.
And the association's had so many great accomplishments in the past year. What are you most proud of?
I'm proud that we have remained true to our mission, and that is to provide those opportunities through our leadership and guidance. And I think we've been true to our mission. And then I'm proud of the fact that we have continued to offer outstanding championships. And now I'm really proud that something that our basketball coaches have wanted for years, that we're able to now have a Final Four type atmosphere for our basketball coaches.
Thank you for your leadership, Commissioner Tucker, and we appreciate your time.
Thank you very much, and I appreciate you all giving me this opportunity, as always, to talk about education-based athletics.
You're watching the Popeyes Halftime Report. Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Here are the best high school hoops plays of the season.
Sports Halftime Report. Okay! Okay! Let's go!
Quick hands with the steal and her control, her ball handling skills, great move there, and a finish at the basket.
Smalls the takeaway, lobs it to the rim, and there is Trey Jones right in the elevator for the easy drop-in. Davis to the short corner, Ifeanyi took a swipe at it, there's a block from the help side defender, Taylor Moore.
It's Yannick on the run and shoot! Absolute pandemonium!
We've got... Givens back up by 11. Reversal, yes! Off the bounce, deep three, Schaefer. Wow, and went to the rafters, dropped through.
Out to Mikulin. Got it! Nolensville wins!
Hard not to be impressed with a season full of highlights in North Carolina and across the country for high school basketball. Tonight, it's all Central Cabarrus. They're in search of back-to-back state titles. 71st has some work to do in this second half, Jay. And let's dive into those first half highlights.
Yeah, it's been up-tempo for the Vikings. They've been able to get to the hoop, and everybody's getting involved, Evan. The three-point shot has fallen, and it's all started on the defensive end. And the bigs with Kent and Dalton have been the two stars, the two leading scorers early on.
Have dominated both with double figures down low. 18 for Kent, 12 for Dalton. DeAndre Nance doing his best, but it's hard to stop this shot blocking machine.
Yeah, just the pace, getting out on the run and getting the crowd into it has been a factor for Central Cabarrus.
Here are the Roderick Todd McIver stats for the first half. Your law offices of Roderick Todd McIver, CYA, call your attorney. 13-70 first turnovers have not helped the cause, but then Central Cabarrus also hitting their threes.
Well, it's all about protecting the basketball, finding good looks for your teammates, and knocking down shots, and they've been able to do it at a high clip and looking to do it here in the second half.
Here are the Piedmont Federal Bank points in the paint for both teams. Piedmont Federal Bank, we invite you to bank better. This department a lot more even, but Central Cabarrus continues to dominate this game.
Yeah, playing inside out, they're doing it at a high level.
We'll take the timeout and get you set for the second half when we return. Welcome back to the 2024 North Carolina High School Athletic Association 3A State Championships presented by West Shore Home. Dominant display from the reigning 3A champ, Central Cabarrus, who have won 64 straight games. They're well in pursuit of 65 so far. 71st wants to play spoiler here with a great second half. So Mylon Campbell attacks the bucket. And the tallest man in the trees there, Josh Dalton, had it for a moment. 71st up and under. Nice finish for Campbell.
Yeah, good work by Campbell. And the goal for the Falcons, first 4 minutes. Let's win it here. Get back in this ballgame. But strong defensive effort leads to offense. They got to start on the defensive side.
That's an airballed three from Noah Edmiston, one of the senior captains on this group. He's made 35 threes this year. And when you rock a headband like that, you got to be a dynamic shooter.
Instead, 71st gets their opening stop. Campbell, nice ball. DeAndre Nance lays it off, and a foul will send Caden Diggs to the line.
Two positive possessions to start off this half. There's the drive, then the dish inside. Diggs was ready for it to get the contact.
71st as a team, 77%. It would only be fitting if they were 71%. This is Carolina Hurricanes free throw. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. Let's go, Canes. 71st has won 17 straight games, including four come-from-behind wins in the second half. They'll need a ton of that here. That's the reigning 3A champions. Desmond Kent lays it off to his 6'9 counterpart, Josh Dalton. Kent on the drive and a swat. Great hands by Nance. And then a travel eliminates transition opportunity.
Excellent work on the defensive end as Kent goes in. Nance was ready for it.
Remember, DeAndre Nance is the starting quarterback for the football team, a state finalist in 3A football. Excellent ball movement. Daniel finds Edmiston. Another miss. And back-to-back stops for 71st. Nance into the front court. Great ball. Foster held in check in that first half. Only 3 points, and he scored 25 in the region final. Nice job off the window from McBride.
Yeah, quick passes, get it into the paint. McBride, he's played really well tonight.
9 assists for 71st so far. They need more of those in the second half. Kent, not much space, and that'll stay here to the surprise of the Fayetteville crowd that's come up. Matchup of a Charlotte-based squad out of the Concord area, Central Cabarrus, and 71st out of Fayetteville, the pride of the 9-1-0. Look at all the movement defensively, and that's tipped out of play. They'll need more activity like that here.
I really like the effort the Falcons are showing here, the intensity on the defensive side. There with a cross-court pass, they helped recover there to knock the ball out of bounds.
And then underneath, no one guarded Daniel for the layup. Let's chase this time. McBride spins it away. Campbell lost it. And now the brothers playing fetch. Here's the three. Knocked in. Carson Daniel on the Meg Brown Home Furnishings 3-point shot. Stopping a Meg Brown today. Take advantage of their anniversary set. Do you get a 2-for-1 special with the twins?
They play really well together.
And down low, another steal for Dalton. They have forced 18 turnovers now. Daniel passes up the three. He drives in and a miss. It's been hard to slow down the Central Cabarrus offense, shooting at 55%. Oh, and then Nance wanted his target to head towards the corner, but couldn't find him.
They're just trying to push the pace. You got to kind of recognize when to go and when to pull the ball back out.
Instead, Chase Daniel goes underneath, and Nance strips it loose. Good hands by the... He's a do-it-all player. Small forward, point guard, quarterback. Elite track athlete as well. Now McBride, great hezzy and a foul. So more aggressive attacking the basket here for Mylon Campbell.
I like how he's playing downhill, forcing the issue and creating the contact. He's got really good handles. And he kind of looked towards the right, then went back to the left to get to the line.
Here's a Carolina Hurricanes free throw line opportunity. Good job there by Mylon Campbell. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. Let's go, Canes. As a team, the 71st club, pretty good at the line, but Campbell himself, 80%. Nice job knocking those in. Having trouble, though, chipping into this lead, and a reach-in foul on Mylon Campbell.
The call didn't go the way for the Falcons, but still, this is a good effort here. They wanted the turnover. They're tight man-to-man defense.
Campbell now back in the grill of Daniel. Carson drives, the lob, and the finish for Dalton. Hard to overcommit against these bigs.
And they can just lob it up, and Dalton, so athletic, he was ready for it.
Now Campbell the other way. He throws a lob, and that ball saved in play. Daniel to Daniel, the dynamic twin duo. Carson has it poked loose. Dalton's there with the foul. Josh Dalton and Fuego here in this third quarter, and we'll take the timeout. Central Cabarrus up 28, and they are rolling here in Winston-Salem. Second chance points aplenty for a club looking for back-to-back state titles. Coming up in the fourth quarter on 9 and 8, Suicide and Crisis Prevention Hotline, play of the game. Call, text, or chat 9 and 8, 24-7. Let's get through it together. And, of course, our West Shore home player of the game. Good competition between Kent Daniels and Dalton for Central Cabarrus. West Shore home, bath remodeling made easy. Here in the 3A state finals, the reigning champs who've won 64 straight games. Central Cabarrus dominant again tonight. It's three and double figures, Jay, and dynamic offense all over the place.
Yeah, and the sharing of the basketball and just the chemistry that they play with. This is a team that's unselfish. It's talented, of course, but they're disciplined and they make the right basketball plays.
Five seniors, six juniors on a club that returned three starters from last year's state title team. Carolina Hurricanes free throw line attempt for Josh Dalton. He could not complete the three-point play. First being outscored in this third quarter after a difficult first half. That look a bit forced, and the tall trees down there. Kent with the board. He's got 18 and 7. What a dynamic athlete. He passes it off to Daniel, who takes his time and puts it in.
And they move so well without the ball. Cutting, slashing. Nice job by Kent finding Daniel.
Jacquez Foster really held in check with 3 points. Nance passes up three. And that'll stay here. Last touch by the Vikings.
And for the Vikings, number 11, Jake Baker.
I realize so much of this core graduates from Central Cabarrus, but a 65-game win streak. I'm curious how long this goes. Foster swings it. Nice drive, but Campbell couldn't hit. Second chance, Mylon Campbell all over it. It's been a nice bright spot for seven.
Yeah, I really like how hard he's playing, creating opportunities because of his hustle.
There's a reach-in foul. That's on Noah Staples, the junior. There's no quit in the 71st team. Beat their Fayetteville rivals Westover in the regional final to get to this championship. And went to the number one seed Swansboro on the road. That was a nice upset win. Right now, no answers for the reigning state champs after a miss from Daniel. Up ahead to Nance. Nance into traffic. That was stripped on the way up. A little scrum. And Daniel wisely uses the timeout. That was Chase Daniel helping out his brother Carson. Central Cabarrus with Dalton, who has 16. Daniels has 11. Kent, 18. Kind of wraps up a great day here in the state championship pairing. Wilson Prep in the 1A men. West Rowan, they've won back-to-back titles. Cherokee, a new champion 25 years later. And now the Vikings, a chance to go back-to-back.
Yeah, today's been fun to watch all these different teams and the matchups. We've got a full day tomorrow as well, but this is a talented set of teams here tonight, and the Vikings will come out here with a big lead. But what a season each side has had throughout the year. So many big wins, dominant playoff runs.
Tomorrow, the matchup of Farmville Central and Reedsville intrigues me at 5 o'clock. Those are two heavy hitters.
The big one, rematch from last year.
It ends the night with New Hanover out of Wilmington and North Mecklenburg, a Charlotte product program. From noon to 8 o'clock, you can follow us all day long tomorrow on your local affiliates and online. Right now, though, Central Cabarrus putting the finishing touches on a back-to-back state championship run. Final games for Carson and Chase Daniel, the twin brothers who have the ball. Chase in attack mode, missed it. Reminds me of the twin brothers of Eamon and Azar Thompson, top five picks from a few years ago, dynamic at the guard positions. Although that time, Nance takes away the fairy tale ending. DeAndre on the move, and a blocking foul, so two shots. We've seen the Robin Brook Lopez's, the Hansborough twin brothers, but at the guard positions, that's next level.
Yeah, I just love the way they play together and the talent they have, and how they set up their teammates and look for their own shots as well. And bright future, Taba, the next level.
What a dynamic Division II programs getting some elite guard play just down the road. After these Carolina Hurricanes free throws, go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be a part of the action. DeAndre Nance to the line, takes advantage of his opportunities. Great spin move, Russell can't get it to go. And now Nance, he is so elusive. Nance the Euro with the foul. DeAndre Nance taking over.
Excellent take by Nance, going all the way, finishing with power.
There's a CR Legal Team fast break. Commitment result, CR Legal Team.
He just goes all the way through the Vikings. Nobody stops ball. He says, I'll go all the way.
So Nance has a team high 9. Him and Campbell are right there, and the court's a little wet, so they're going to dry that off. How about for that young man, though? State quarterback finalist, state finalist with the basketball team. Is he a great leader? We've talked to all the coaches on that staff, and they love DeAndre Nance.
I just love the intensity that he plays with and the fact that he plays multiple sports. And he's a leader, not only basketball, football team, but in this school. Jeremy Ingram and his staff, they got a great group of kids.
Fifth ever appearance for 71st in a state final. Looking to resurrect an entire town of Fayetteville that's searching for their first champion since the late 60s on the men's basketball side. And a foul underneath. Final game of the night here with the Joels, the 3A men's championship. We'll start right early tomorrow, 2A and 4A alternating. And a foul on the floor. That's his third personal for Milan. Hold on, they weren't ready for play. Okay, we are in the bonus. So free throws here. I knew that B graphic would come in handy. Chase Daniel with his twin brother Carson, and known as Dogs in this program, and they are really grinding away for this team. Three straight years as starters. And now in comes Josh Dalton after the Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be part of the action. Let's go, Kings.
Well, what an amazing experience for these seniors that are in this program. All those wins, Evan.
Have lost one game in the last 2 years. 64 straight wins and another bucket for Chase Daniel. Chase and Carson grinding together in the middle of the court. That's a broken press from Staples. Now a loose scrum. There's a good shot for Jacques Foster, looking to see him get going today.
Yeah, Foster, really good shooter from the outside. Good to see a look by him going in towards the hoop.
Russell's turn. Oh, nifty drive, and he's fouled. Becoming a little bit of a free throw game here, and foul issues for 71st popping up. Diggs has 2, Campbell 3, Staples 3, and now a fourth for Staples. The Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets. Be part of the action. Let's go, Canes. 24 combined free throw attempts between the programs. An ad well spent by the Hurricanes. After a nice 4-0 win for Carolina last night over the Florida Panthers. The battle for the Canes, if you will. The Miami area team for the Panthers. Here's a loose scrum on the missed free throw. And Central Cabarrus gets it back. Here's Edmiston hitting the three. That's Jake Baker, in fact, from downtown on the Meg Brown Home Furnishings triple. Stopping to Meg Brown today to take advantage of their anniversary sale. And a turnover there for 71st.
And the Vikings do such a good job with the ball reversal there. Daniel going across the court, and Baker, feet set, the rotation, knocking it in.
Lead is ballooned to 25. Mylon Campbell, 1v4. Foster a bit short. And here comes Chase Daniel. He's fouled in the open court. Nance thought he picked his pocket. And instead, more free throws. Chase Daniel has 6 assists tonight. He's been setting up his teammates. And his brother Carson has 11 points. Back to the Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. Go to hurricanes.com/tickets to be part of the action. Let's go, Canes. Largest lead of the game now late in this third quarter for Central Cabarrus in search of back-to-back 3A state titles. DeAndre Nance breaks the press. First minutes here for Tyreek Perez, number 20 in the red, the senior guard. One of 3 seniors for Coach Jeremy Ingram. And Perez will earn free throws. Nance will earn free throws.
71st. This is a group having only 3 seniors on this year's ball club. A lot of talent coming back next year. It's one of those juniors that'll be back.
And how about those moments? Jeremy Ingram spending time with his son right now. The former NC Central standout, spent years overseas in Argentina playing hoops. And now he's mentoring the next generation of coaches.
And this is his calling. That's what he said, that he's meant to be here to mentor these kids in this program. And what a job he's done.
Making a huge impact here at 71st. He's only 32 years old, by the way, coaching the staff. That's a miss on a 3. Russell no good on the tip. And here come the Falcons. Oh, nice 3 for Foster. He's got 8 points. A Meg Brown Home Furnishings 3-point shot. Stopping to Meg Brown today to take advantage of their anniversary sales. That wraps up the third quarter. Let's go to the fourth in this 3A state title battle. Central Cabarrus dominant so far, and they're 8 minutes away from a 3A state championship. Offices of Roderick Todd McIver, stats for the third quarter. Call your attorney. Dominant free throw shooting for 71st, but great offense for Central Cabarrus. Also, our Piedmont Federal Bank points in the paint for both teams in the third quarter. Central Cabarrus dominant down low. And Piedmont Federal Bank invites you to bank better. 71st plus 4 in the third, but hard to crack into this 22-point deficit. As Central Cabarrus 8 minutes away from back-to-back state titles. Daniel, the no-look pass for his brother, and that goes out of play. Such chemistry between those two. One has 6 assists, one has double-figure points.
Yeah, and they both have similar skill set. Some games, one will go off scoring the ball, the other playing great defense, and they just play so well off of each other.
Both combined for 37 in the regional final win over Hickory. As that is last touch by... They'll stay here, actually. That Hickory game was a real turning point. Central Cabarrus was down in the second half. They overcame a big deficit. And 71st, they were in a grind with their in-city rivals, Westover, and then blew them out, up 19 to pull away. There's Tyreek Perez into traffic. That's no good. see Dalton begging for the ball down low. He has 16, too shy of Kent for the team lead. Daniel instead on a drive, and he beats his defender.
Oh, it's so tough when you've got a defender on your hip to finish. He's a skilled player.
DeAndre Nance, the junior, he'll be back next year to anchor this football program and the basketball team. Misses the layup. A lot of pride in the 9-1-0 for high school sports down there. Here's a three. Oh, what a finish for Chase Daniel, the Meg Brown Home Furnishing three-point shot. Stopping at Meg Brown today to take advantage of their anniversary sale happening now. Good contest by Dalton. Here's Kent, the kick out. Edmiston misses. Loose ball, and it's just too easy for Central Cabarrus.
Yeah, they're just continuing on here with their excellent play. Third quarter and now into the fourth quarter.
Nice dump off. That one a bit forced. I've liked the effort of Caden Diggs, but it's been hard down there against the Giants. And not like Penguins of Madagascar, the New York Giants. But the Giants of Kent combining with Dalton for 35 points. Here's Dalton. He uses the shot fake and two more.
Excellent. And the fundamentals of Dalton is what really separates his game. Yes, he has athleticism and talent, but we can use that shot fake to get the defender off balance. It creates extra space and an open look.
Nance backing down the smaller Daniel, who then gets the steal. He throws a prayer. Kent, the lob! Dalton missed it. Nearly cinematic here at Winston-Salem.
Yeah, they were going for it here. They knew what was about to happen.
They actually had a great shot to throw that in.
Yeah.
Instead, a 31-point game in the final 5 minutes of this 3A state title. Foster's had a nice second half. He'll cut in. And that one falls home. 10 points for Foster. He'll be a junior back on this team with Nance next year. Another lob, and Kent couldn't hit it. Numbers here for 71st. Foster's playing a nice game, clanging around the rim for two more.
Yeah, he's gotten it going here in the second half. Good take by him.
This will be a 65th straight win for the Vikings of Central Cabarrus. They have dominated here in 3A basketball the last 2 years. There's an open three. Wow, what a start. These shots are heating up. Remember, Central Cabarrus after that Meg Brown Home Furnishings deep shot. Final 4 minutes. Lost in the title game in 22, won in 23, and now here in 24, a chance to make it 2 of 3. This is an impressive run. We'll take the timeout, get you all set to wrap up this state title game. Big day for Jim Baker's program. They're up 24 as this game is brought to you by West Shore Home for the 3A state title. Cabarrus knock on the door of history as back-to-back state champions in the 3A North Carolina bracket. It's been a minute. Cox Mill, the last back-to-back champ in 17-18. This is a dominant performance for the Vikings tonight.
They've looked so good. And from the opening tip, they've really taken hold of this game. And 71st is a really good team. And they just haven't been able to get into a rhythm, but that's because of the outstanding defense and the offensive execution of Central Cabarrus.
DeAndre Nance battling to the final minutes. He has 12 points, but no good on that one. On this end, Kent Jr., he's in double figures with 20. And then Dalton's forward counterpart has 18. Here's Dalton's turn. He goes up and slams it in. Okay, noted, 20 apiece. Wow.
just sitting here on floor level to see how he elevates. So impressive.
Now it's Kent with the steal. They've also forced 25 turnovers tonight. There's Daniel. Hit it off his own noggin. I guess that's a dribble technique. Daniel back to his brother. Look at him passing here. Carson 1v1. Edmiston loses it, but that'll actually be okay. Remember, no shot clock in high school basketball here in North Carolina. So Dalton says, cheers, I got 22. Nice jumper there for Tyreek Perez, the senior, one of three seniors for 7-1.
Good to see the senior knock one in.
And the brother-to-brother connection's on point. Which one do you think lifts the trophy first?
They do it at the same time. And now the coaches, each side, giving some of the players an opportunity to come into this game.
Time now for a West Shore Home Player of the Game. West Shore Home Bath Remodeling made easy. And it's the presence of Kent down low. And
Kent's been all over the floor. Hustle plays, finishing around the hoop. And he has showed off his supreme talent tonight.
He's raising the roof for 20 himself and has been subbed out with both teams going to the bench. Look at those stat lines for Desmond Kent Jr.
So versatile. He can impact the ball game in so many ways, and he makes his teammates better.
That'll be the final game in a Viking uniform for the two-time state champ, DJ Kent Jr. He'll be heading to Lisa McCray next year and hugging it out with his big teammate, Josh Dalton. Both teams heading deep to the bench now. Daquan Dunn, the junior guard, comes in at point guard along with Anthony Bethea. And now a steal for Amari Russell. And a late foul there on Micah Dowdy Issam, the senior forward. Want to make sure we give all these new players some love. Caden Smith, the junior guard, has come in. Jake Baker remains in the game, and also first minutes for Larquise Burst Jones, the junior forward. This is the Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. Visit hurricanes.com to be a part of the action. Let's go, Canes. A loose ball will get the ball back to Central Cabarrus, who's about to win their 65th straight game. No team has done it better in high school hoops.
Haven't had any off nights, have they?
One loss in the last 3 years. Such an impressive run. As we're near the final minute and a half, that ball gets kicked around and goes out of bounds. Their toughest test was the regional final against Hickory, and they have dominated since. 71st will drop to 0-5 all time in state finals, but to get there two of the last 3 years, so impressive.
It is, and I think each team should be so proud of what they've been able to accomplish this year.
Nice teardrop for Daquan Dunn, his first points. Both teams have gone deep into their benches here as we're near the final minute. Remember, no shot clock in high school hoops, so these teams could take it down. Here's a three, and a nice signature moment for Caden Smith. That's a Meg Brown Furnishings three-point shot. Stop at a Meg Brown today to take advantage of their anniversary sale. On this end, a foul opportunity for Micah Dowdy Issam in this 71st program. It's not just the players on the court. It's the coaches influencing their young generation. Ahead of the Carolina Hurricanes free throw line. There's Jeremy Ingram and his son. Jeremy, of course, a fantastic player at NC Central in his tenure and teaching some life moments for his kid. These are hard moments when you lose in the biggest game, but it is a nice moment to teach.
You share your experiences with your family and Baker to Baker there, and everybody enjoying this, the Viking sideline.
Central Cabarrus has now entered its bench. Infinite Morrow with an elite name, he comes in. And Morrow grabs the basketball. Also, Kevontae Martin, the junior, has checked in, and a steal. Perez, the layup the other way. It is great to see every single player on both teams come in tonight.
Yeah, and get an opportunity to play in this atmosphere and here at Wake Forest, something they'll always remember.
Perez with a couple of buckets here in the closing seconds. As we wrap up the final moments of this 3A state title, and a nice bucket there for guess who? It's Caden Smith. Or pardon me, that's Camden Lowry. Everyone has checked in for both teams. But right now, it's the Kings of 3A basketball. Central Cabarrus putting the finishing touches on back-to-back state titles and a 65-game win streak. No stopping one of the best teams in the nation doing what they've done all year. Dominate opponents, a 33-0. Perfect regular season. And Jay, what a dynamic performance.
It's been fun to watch them tonight and just how they execute, and a special opportunity to go back-to-back in the 71st. Outstanding season. They'll use this as fuel, motivation the offseason. I expect them to be back in this game again.
Here's tonight's 988 Suicide and Crisis Prevention Play of the Game. Call, text, or chat 988-247. And it's the second chance dunks of this dynamic forward group. Kent had a dunk, followed up by his counterpart down low in Dalton. And everyone getting involved in the dunks tonight. What a fun dunk party. Let's get through it together at 988 Suicide and Crisis Prevention Hotline Play of the Game. Great performance from the 3A state champs, Central Cabarrus. They'll win back-to-back and bring the title home to the Charlotte area just outside of Concord later tonight. And it's ring time. That's right, Desmond Kent. There's the victorious coach, Jim Baker. He has a nice word for a longtime great coach, Jeremy Ingram, as well. And the celebration is on for Vikings country. We're getting Coach Jim Baker ready to talk to Jay here in just a second. And now we're ready, so Jay Sunhalter, take it away.
All right, Coach, 65 wins in a row. What's your secret?
Yeah, I got good players, and they are, and we call them dogs, and then they love to play, they love to compete. If we took them over to the rec center right now, they play just as hard, and they're great kids, and they're what college and sports and high school sports is all about. They're great kids, they're student athletes, they're going to do well, and I'm so proud of them. They get after it now.
The talent is evident. But what really strikes me is how well they play together as a true team. Where do they get that from?
Well, they're just good kids, and they want to win. That's number one. They're going to be on the Xbox playing when we get home tonight. I mean, they're the close together. They do everything together. And they genuine love and care for each other. And it's evident out here the way they play. I don't know how many assists we have, but probably 25 plus. And they just love to compete, and they're easy to coach. We talk in code. I know it, nod with them, you know, this and that. And it's been a pleasure with coaching this senior bunch.
Before they get on the Xbox, you're going to celebrate. This is back-to-back. What makes this one so special?
Well, we lost five seniors, and they're all sitting over there. They were dying to go to the locker room with us, and I thought we were going to be pretty good. But my role players, Amari number 12, my son Jake Baker, Edmund's son, Caden Smith, they figured out how to play. And when they figured out, and then with the big four out there, it was just seamless. And they're so competitive, and they love to play. And, you know, we've been here before. The neat thing about it, and I simplify everything, we're going to run our simplest stuff, and we're just going to outplay them. And boy, it came through. They were awesome tonight.
Congratulations, Coach. You're a state champion once again.
It's a good feeling. I'm so proud of my school, my administration, and I got a good situation. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you, Coach Baker. Congrats to his son, of course, on the championship. We'll step aside for a moment and come back to hand out the trophies here in the 3A state championship. Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Here are your law offices of Roger Todd McIver's final stats. CYA Collier attorney. Great offense for Central Cabarrus tonight. And down the stretch, she's too much. Those 24 turnovers, the big difference for 71st.
Falcon just couldn't get into a groove. And Central Cabarrus protected the basketball. They shot the ball from a high level. But Evan, it all started on the defensive end tonight.
Here's our final Piedmont Federal Bank points in the paint, plus 20 in a game that was pulled out in dominant fashion. At Piedmont Federal Bank, we invite you to bank better. You just heard from Coach Baker, back-to-back titles. His son and the crew have run the table twice in a row, and now we'll step aside and let you listen in for the trophy presentation.
Number 22, Noah Edmondson. Number 24, Carson Daniel. Number 30, Caden Smith. Number 31, Curtis Pickett. Number 32, Marquise Hurst-Jones. Number 33, Captain Lowry. Number 34, Desmond Kent. Number 40, Chinwai Izebo. And number 45, Infinite Morrow.
Jim Baker, the moment is yours for your program. Two straight championships. Time to lift that bad boy up and celebrate here in Winston-Salem.
And the head coach for the state champions to come forward to receive their 3A men's championship.
It's the 3A men's champions back to back. Dominant at that. They have been the talk of North Carolina the last 3 years. Fantastic, and the team goes in to celebrate. Well, I take a moment to thank our wonderful sponsors here all day. West Shore Home, Popeyes, the North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services, Brittle and Brantley, Meg Brown Home Furnishings, the law offices of Roderick Todd McIver, Piedmont Federal Bank, CR Legal, the Carolina Hurricanes, and Ingles Markets. All your sponsorships make this day fantastic. It was a dominant run for Central Cabarrus, the 3A class champions. This broadcast is presented by West Shore Home. What a day. Tomorrow we all begin again with the 4A Women's Championship right here in Winston-Salem. For Jay Sunhalter and our talented crew, I'm Evan Budrovich. We say good night as Central Cabarrus repeats as state champions.